Can't move! There's a med kit!
Hello guys, mi nombre es el Deon Russo de la Muerda. I don't speak Spanish. Actually, if I did speak Spanish, I'd probably rename myself to Hugo La Cerda, but I don't. So, welcome back to some more Final Stand on CTE, and I know you're going to want to know about the changes that have been made since the last time that I've updated you about CTE, because obviously it's a brand new patch with this whole community test environment. We're totally fixing the game, despite the fact that we somehow missed the Sarlacc pit, but I'm just going to rapid fire run through the 12 most important changes that I saw that you're going to want to know about. I'm going to cater to you as an MLG Battlefield player and cut out all the fat and all the information that you don't need to know. So, starting with the first piece of information, which is nearly all the vehicles have a slightly different HUD color now. ATVs and snowmobiles still explode if you try to perform a trick that you saw during the X Games. The hover tank still acts exactly like a Beyblade, although the aiming system is still clunky, it's slightly better. My advice to you is to act like you're the Kool-Aid man and just bust into everything. No shells or bullets needed. Oh yeah! The new knife looks like a pair of scissors when you prone dance too rapidly. The drone slash occipiter slash UAV thing is still extremely effective, yet equally as annoying. There are new hit markers where you can customize the size and whether or not they scale in size when they inflict more damage. You can still create double hover tank Voltron if you try hard enough, and trust me, it is the most terrifying vehicle on the battlefield. There is some sort of new Jesus Lav that can drive on water. Not float, but drive. I don't get it either, but thanks, DICE. The pods on Hangar 21 have changed quite a bit. There's a brand new HUD, you have to charge it up before launching, you can't sit idle in the launcher for more than 15 seconds without it automatically kicking you out, and they've added one on the E-flag, so that's a thing. Ghosting, or team killing with vehicles, is no longer a thing, and I'm pretty sure Chaboy and Azzy are gonna cry themselves to sleep tonight. Closing doors are even more of a hazard now than they were before, yet they are still absolutely terrifying. And with all that out of the way, let's move on to the railgun, something that I've been whoring out so much lately that even one of the devs called me out on it. After a few no-scopes and blasting them out of a helicopter with it, TomTom even said, "Try the railgun, it's Badger's favorite," as if to say, "Come on guy, let somebody else use it." So of course, being the man that I am, I took the high road and maturely told him that he was mad 'cause bad. But I digress. I think you get the point that I'm using it too much. And now that I've had more time to use it, I think that the Rorsch, or the railgun, or the ray gun, or that thing that blasts you when I'm standing above you, get dunked on, whatever you want to call it, Mr. Gmon Freak 7. I think it always has to be evaluated or thought about in the context of the other pickup weapons. I know somebody, "Oh my god, the Rorsch is overpowered, the railgun is super..." Yes, but you're not thinking about the other pickup weapons that you have at your disposal that are probably equally as lethal, if not more. So think about this. So, you know, you got your USAS, your MGL, your AMR, your 50 cal, or your Barrett. I think plenty of those have lots and lots of broken features compared to regular assault rifles, but that's the reason that they're pickup weapons. They're much harder to come by, and that makes sense to me. So think about the USAS. I think that's probably the worst pickup you can get, just because you're still going to take four bullets to kill the guy because of the splash damage with frag rounds, and oftentimes, you know, anything with a high rate of fire can probably dunk you in close range if you have some moderate accuracy at your disposal. So I don't think the USAS is really, really good, but I think in certain contexts with clusters of enemies, it can be effective. The MGL is much, much better at that sort of thing. So think about it. You got six shots and a revolver grenade launcher, and if you come around a corner and there's eight dudes having a gab fest, I don't know, reading Yu-Gi-Oh! Or something, or playing Yu-Gi-Oh! You just activated my trap card, then there would be a reasonable chance you could probably blast all those guys away, because it has so much damage so quickly, especially with the splash damage in a certain area. It's extremely lethal in that specific situation. But are you going to be sniping dudes on the other end of the map, or are you going to headshot somebody from 800 meters away? Absolutely not. Not with the MGL. And then there is where the 50 cal and the AMR enter. So, yet again, if you ran around that same corner trying to kill those dudes playing Yu-Gi-Oh! With an AMR, you wouldn't be able to kill all eight of them or all six of them. I don't even know. The cluster of guys, whatever that number happened to be, you're not going to be able to kill all of them with the AMR. Unless you've got a serious collat going on there, you're not going to be able to do it. But at the same time, are you going to be able to kill that guy all the way across the map or 800 meters away? Yes, you are with the AMR. And keep in mind that the AMR and the 50 cal are the same in terms of you can hit him in the toenail, you can hit him in the face. Either way, one bullet is going to put him down at any distance. Obviously, the 50 cal has a bit of an advantage there just because it's semi-auto instead of being a bolt action, so you don't have to unzoom, change your bolt, get a new round in there, and then fire again. So just in terms of rate of fire, obviously the 50 cal is better than the AMR, but they both serve that purpose of, I can hit you across the map, bruh! And yet again, it doesn't matter where you hit him. And now enter the Rorsch, alright? This is how the Rorsch, or the railgun, fits into everything else as I hit people that are parachuting. Obviously, very, very good against vehicles. And you'll see there that the splash damage will get you oftentimes multi-kills when there's clusters of enemies, but I don't think that's extremely effective when compared to something like the MGL. So I think the splash damage might need to be toned down a little bit, but I by no means think that the Rorsch is overpowered. First thing, the reload is absolutely atrocious. I believe it's 8.5, maybe 9 seconds per round. I mean, think about how many people you can go bang, bang, bang. I think there's like over, is it 8 to 10 rounds with a 50 cal? So you could put down so many guys in that same span when you would immediately be reloading with the roar. So I think the reload balances out quite a bit. It doesn't one-shot vehicles. Now, oftentimes you can, if you shoot at the cabin, like the side gunner seat, or you shoot at the bottom of the helicopter, oftentimes you can throw it off or imbalance it to the point where it crashes. So oftentimes you can take it down in one shot, but it doesn't necessarily explode in one shot. And yet again, I just think the reload, it balances it out. So overall, I don't think that the Rorsch is overpowered. I think that people are crying and they're not really understanding the context with the other pickup weapons. And I think they need to just stop being mad 'cause bad, all right? Mad 'cause bad. That's all I have to say about that. For your bonus clip, I'm going to show you some long-lost footage that I have of the SC-42 before it was nerfed. I'll see you guys next time. Auf Wiedersehen und bis bald und later.